We step in with a soft joy because this is the time of the divine feminine. This is the time that we breathe with you into these feminine vessels. And all that has come to pass as the feminine has evolved on this planet, or should we say, has come back in her evolution from the light into the shadows and now back into the light. And dear shining children of ours, you are those lights. You are that evolution. And we are with you always. Your days may seem usual. They may seem unaffected by your connection to the Star Mothers. But do not ever doubt that we are with you. And again, you are always with us. And you can call on us at any time. That spark of your Pleiadian divinity that lives inside of you is connected to us. Sometimes it's like a microphone that we hear you. Sometimes it's a whisper, and we reach closer to you and closer to you until you remember to ask us. We remind you, though you all know, in this free will universe, we will not interrupt or disrupt any patterns that you are having without your permission. But you have created here a bond of women who have spent other lives together, not all at once, but other lives and other times. And now here you are in this, your 21st millennium, a time of the great shift into the great rebalancing. And that is what the divine feminine is bringing to your planet, the great rebalancing. And each one of you is so important, beloved ones. And this is a great responsibility, and yet a joyful responsibility, that you knew when you came into this life. It may be just awakening for you, and you have much more to reach into to discover the depths of your mission and your passion here. This may just be the beginning. And if once again, we will use Mele'ha as an example. She likes to say, as old as a tree, and new beginnings are still happening for her. So wherever you are in the calendar of life, it doesn't matter. You are creating your life with your intention. Hold that spark, fan it into a flame, and become a torch for other women. Sometimes you may need to stand close to another torch to remember what your journey is. And again, we encourage this through community. Unity through community. We like that teaching, and we like to tell you again, because you are strong women, and sometimes you tend to be on your own and do it on your own and not reach out and look weak. This is a misconception. When you reach out, when you ask for support, for help, for information, for guidance, you look stronger. You are stronger because you know that support is there for you. And then in your turn, of course, you will give support. That is what community is about. Take a breath, please. The learning that you have received will continue to unfold. Our suggestion is that you write about your new insights, your intuitions, your integrations. This is very important, that you take time to integrate and then to touch back in this circle and to have other women join you in this circle. For there is a great need in every community for these circles. You may just find one or 10, but you know already, each of you knows someone who is ready to open to the love and support and the compassion of a sacred circle, of a community of women. Whether it be Lemurian, Pleiadian, Arcturian, English, Dutch, or French, women are women everywhere. And you are at the front of the wave, beloved shining ones. You are the wake-up crew, and you are learning more and more about yourself and what you're here to do. As each time you say yes to another sacred assignment. And no, sacred assignments are not just for Mele'ha, they are for everyone. Again, we have used her as an example with that. But your leader there in your circle, Anne, she answered the sacred assignment call. And now she is moving forward with it. And all of you in your own way. But as you begin to believe more and more in yourselves and in your own magnificence, you will begin to enjoy the gifts, the challenges, the unfolding of each sacred assignment. And we tell you, just say yes, because they are an adventure. And as in any good adventure, your traveling companions will step up. They will find you. You will find them. And you will take a journey together. That is when you discover each other's gifts and wisdom. And isn't that one of the beautiful things about community? You each have unique gifts and wisdom to share and to develop. Take another breath. We understand this is a lot to take in between what Mele'ha said and what we are saying now. But we know you are ready because you are here. So, in closing, we ask you this for your evening. We ask you to spend time every day in the next 6 days, even if you can only spend a few minutes. Spend time tuning in, touching in to that sacred place inside of you that is being nurtured right now, that is being nourished and wants to grow. We are always with you. And of course, a spark of us is always inside of you. Remember, all you need to do is ask. Just a thought, and we are there. For now, we say, You are sacred ones. And we step back. Take a breath. This is a good time to take a stretch. Stretch your arms up, maybe shake your hands, move your body a little. Oh, yeah. Thank you, beautiful goddesses, for sharing this sacred space with me. It's been really an honor.